In this video, we will demonstrate how to seamlessly integrate a logo of your organization into your Pi signage display on top of the running playlist. Additionally, we will show you how to customize its placement on the screen. Now, let's proceed with a step-by-step demo. Make sure you have your logo ready in PNG format. In this demo, we will be working with a player group with its resolution set to 1080p. For the best logo display with this group resolution, we recommend using a logo with dimensions between 140 and 180 pixels for both height and width. For the demo, we will be utilizing the Pi signage logo with a dimension of 150 by 150 pixels. Note that it is crucial to test your logo on the display, experimenting with different sizes to determine the optimum size of the logo for your display based on the resolution of your player group. Let us first upload this logo to our Pi signage account. Go to the Assets section. Click on Add. Select Upload Files. Choose your logo image. Again, please note that the logo asset should be in PNG format. For this demo, we are uploading an image named Pi Logo 150px. To keep your assets organized, it is advisable to assign your asset to an existing category or create a new category for your uploaded assets. In this demo, we will create a category called Logo for our logo asset. Ignore the Add Validity Period option, as it is not necessary in this case. Click on Continue. Your logo asset will be uploaded to your account. Now, go to the Groups section and select the player group in which you want to display your logo. In this demo, we will select the group named Demo Group. This group is already deployed with a playlist, which you can see running on screen. To add your logo to this display, click on the Settings button in the top right corner. A pop-up page will open. Scroll down to the Show Logo section and click on Select Image. Choose the logo image that you have uploaded to your account. You can filter by name to find the logo. Next, we will define the position of the logo on the screen. The X and Y positions determine the horizontal and vertical positioning of the logo respectively and are defined in terms of pixels. By default, both the X and Y positions are set to 10, which places the logo on the top left corner of the screen as shown. For now, let's leave the default values. Scroll down and click OK. Then, redeploy the group. You can now see the Pi signage logo displayed on the top left corner of the screen. Now, let's change the logo position to the top right corner of the screen. To do this, go back to the group settings. The Y position, or the vertical positioning of 10 pixels, is appropriate and we will leave it as it is. For the X position, we will change it to 1760 pixels. The reasoning behind this is, as per our group resolution setup, the display width will be 1920 pixels. The logo's width is 150 pixels and we want a gap of 10 pixels after the logo. So, the X position is derived by subtracting these two values, that is 150 pixels and 10 pixels, from the screen width, that is 1920 pixels. After entering 1760 as the X position, click on OK and redeploy the group. Now you can see the logo placed on the top right corner of the screen. It is important to choose the X and Y positions for the logo optimally, based on your group's resolution. The appropriate size or dimension of the logo to be displayed is also defined by the group resolution setup. For example, the logo size of 150 pixels that we used in this demo may appear oversized and disproportionate if the group resolution is set at 720p. Therefore, it is recommended to experiment with different logo dimensions and positions to arrive at the most appropriate setup for your display. If you have any questions or need assistance, please reach out to us at info@pisignage.com.